We are live on a Friday night, which is kind of weird. We are never live on Friday nights, and we almost didn't go live tonight because YouTube was having some situations, but we refixed our modem, so maybe it was us, not them.
I don't know. It's hard to say.
We're excited because we're going to be decoupaging tonight. We are doing our craft box. If you guys didn't know, we have subscription boxes at jrvhome.com. They're only open for a certain amount of time and then they close. These subscription boxes are mailing out today and we're including this link in the subscription box so people know how to do their crafts.
Well, today, tomorrow morning.
I mean, there's 61 boxes right over there waiting for the link.
Okay, so what these are these are tree cutouts, and we're going to be decoupaging them, painting them, doing fun things to them. It's going to come apart, right? So one side is a little tighter, and I designed it like that on purpose so that it will freestand. If you get it to this point and you're like, man, that's kind of tight because Utah's pretty dry, and depending on where we send these, you might have a little more humidity than us, and your wood might swell up and it might be tight. So you can just take your fingers, push it down like that, and if that still doesn't do it, you can give it like a little whack like this. You don't want to go crazy because you...
A little whack? Can you show us that again? This is
like
essential
this. So let's say it's raised up, right? Hold on, now I got it in there.
Don't
really
break
tight.
It. Once it's in there, just leave it in there.
Yeah, once it's in there, don't manhandle it. All right, so let's let's say it's just right there like that. You can just...
That's loud.
And it's going in, okay? And it'll go down and seat flush, done. It'll stand. That's the way I designed it.
If you guys did not order a decoupage box or a subscription box, it's too late to get this one. But you can still purchase the trees. It's just as not as good of a deal. So the next time we open up subscription boxes, make sure you sign up because you're going to get the better deal. Let me
When's
drop
that
link.
Happening? Like in...
A couple weeks once we get the next design out.
Yeah.
I'm dropping the link right now for the trees. They are $19.95. If you got the subscription box, you are going to get this trees. You're going to get one new Zibra brush, which you can do the entire project with the brush. You'll have to wash it in between steps. You're going to get white wax, farmhouse finishes in tavern green, and Sweet Pickens suitcase. And I don't have it here, but you're going to get 2 ounces of top coat, so twice the size of top coat. And you get two sheets of decoupage paper. It's about 1/4 of the big decoupage.
And it
papers.
Is random. Your sheets may look different than this.
Yeah, it's all the same sheet. This is the Christmas Stag Music decoupage paper that we carry. But we cut them into pieces so that way you could use them for your project. So we're going to get started and show you what we're doing. And if you're watching the replay, I'm going to put the links to what you can buy in the description box. But like I said, if you guys signed up for the subscription box, you're always going to get the best deal and get all the things you need to do your project. But if you didn't sign up, don't worry. You can still get some trees.
All right. So I'm going to paint the base and the trunks with the brush, and I'm just going to put the whole amount in.
It's 1 ounce of the milk paint, and you want to mix it one part milk paint to one part water. I just go a little bit at a time with the water because if you go too much, it's too watery and it's a pain. I like mine a little
thicker. I basically just filled up the little sample jar again. Do we have something to mix it with? Are we prepared enough for that?
I was just going to use the brush.
Okay. I like the brush mix
method. If you're not mixing a lot of milk paint, it's not hard. Do you need more water?
A little more, yeah.
Okay.
But I have some.
Get all that milk paint goodness out of there.
Get it all out.
I think the next time we do this, I'm going to use Ziploc bags because these little pots were expensive. I didn't think about that until I was packing 60 boxes today with Jean and Christy, and I was like...
Save your pots. Do something fun with them.
Yeah. Well, they're not expensive, but I mean, it adds up.
Okay. Now I'm going to paint the base.
All right. When you're done, pass me the brown, and I'll paint the base. You're going to have more paint than you need for this little project. So my suggestion is don't mix up your entire pot. Maybe only mix up like half your pot, and then you could save that for something else because you really don't need this much milk paint.
Yeah, a little goes a long way, and this is a small project.
Mix it up good or you're going to get chunks like Zeb.
And if you want, you could also glue these bases in. I don't know that it's necessary, but, you know.
Jean's on here. Woo-woo! Hey, Jean. So Jean works with me, and I'm going to add her as a moderator. Woo-hoo! She helped me, along with Christy, work on all of the boxes. I packed all 15 of the thrift boxes today, and the 6 home decor boxes. In fact, Jean's daughter Tanea is coming in tomorrow to make sure they all get shipped out. I actually had a lot of fun doing the thrift boxes because I got to pick all the things I wanted to fill them with, and that was fun. And it was also very satisfying to do the craft boxes because it was like an assembly line. Me and Christy and Jean worked together, and we just like filled all the boxes. It was good. All
right, my base and my tree trunks are painted.
So this is Suitcase by Sweet Pickens. Milk paint is really great for crafting because if you didn't get the craft kit and you want to buy it, you can buy it in a sample. And a sample of milk paint is only $6. And it's going to come with 2 ounces in a sample. That makes 4 ounces of milk paint. And that's actually way more than you would need for a small project like this. So I love milk paint for projects.
So I think I've only dipped my brush once.
Yeah, and it's all natural and food safe. So if you're painting kids' toys or you're painting inside a house or you're making something that's going to come in contact with food, then it is a really great option. And to be perfectly honest, we're going to seal these, but you don't have to seal home decor. This milk paint is not coming off.
It's going to sit on the shelf.
Yeah, it's going to sit somewhere. So do you want to dry that and then we'll get started on the green?
Yeah. Okay. Okay, heat gun. Also not necessarily.
Necessarily?
Necessarily. Necessary. I had like 6 minutes while I was trying to get the internet working, so watch out.
All right, so for January, I am open to subjections.
I've passed it on to you.
What are you doing? I'm open for suggestions for the craft box. Keep in mind that the boxes are, I think, $36.95, so it can't cost $2 million. And they can't be ginormous to ship because we only charge $8.95 for our subscription boxes for the shipping. So comment with what you'd like to do for January. I don't know if we should do something for Valentine's Day or if we want to do something
I think
like
something
organizing.
For spring, because the next one would be summer,
storage.
And then a fall, and then a winter one.
No, that you get January, and then spring, and then summer, and then, yeah.
Oh, so at the beginning of the year, we kick off with January.
Yeah, January is when the next box
So you sign up soon
ship.
For that, and it'll have a first of the year craft.
Maybe some wooden box situations for organizing.
Oh, I like that.
Lolly said spring, not Valentine's. I would agree with that. I think Valentine's Day is cute, but not everybody decorates for Valentine's Day.
Okay.
Let's be honest. I'm thinking next time it's going to be something that comes with a custom stencil.
Ooh.
Ooh, and maybe a stencil brush. All right, I've got brown paint everywhere. Okay, you want to mix up the green paint?
Yeah, let me go clean this brush and I'll let you get them.
Well, I got extra brushes. We don't have time for that.
Okay.
You only get one brush.
If you're at home and you're doing the craft, wash your brush.
But I brought extras because we're live and people don't have time to watch us.
Watch us go wash our brush?
Watch me. Can I have the heat gun though?
Yes.
You know what would also be cute? When you guys get these, you can use what comes in the kit, but don't be afraid to improvise, right? Like, I'm giving you the basics, but I can't wait to see in the Facebook group, the January Vintage Facebook group, what everybody does. Because generally, you guys are better than me. I come up with a basic
idea.
Well,
you know, and you're gonna get, like, 60 different ideas on how to do something and accomplish it.
Yep.
I didn't go slow and just put all of that in there at once.
Gene and I have been spending a lot of time together. Yesterday we got ready for the Stay at Home Shopping Network. If you guys didn't watch that, make sure you check that out because we got a ton of fun new Christmas stuff in. And there are a few things that did not sell out. So
this is a really great Christmas tree green.
All the products we're using today you can find at jamierayvintage.com. And we do have 6 sheets of the Christmas Dear Music Stag paper left. And what he's going to be using is 1/4 of what the whole sheet is. So you get a ton of paper with each sheet. I'll show you in a little bit. I'm using a different one, and I'll show you how big the decoupage paper is. The other thing that's nice about milk paint is it's pretty self-leveling. Now, I think I'm going to do a second coat. Can I have that brown?
Yes.
You can also sand it to smooth it out if you want to. And you could also paint your whole tree brown if you wanted to distress back to the brown color. I was actually thinking if you had some brown left over when you were all done, you could water it way down and kind of do like an antique wash.
That would look really cool
yeah.
in there.
I mean, waste not want not, right?
Well, we use the watered down milk paint for stains.
Yeah. Christy wants one of these, and I'm thinking we have another one that broke that we fixed.
I you know what? It was like 1 a.m. last night, and I was cranking through these. I had a little mini assembly line of one going on. I was cutting the blanks out and then putting them on the machine, and then I'd sand them as they came off the machine, and, you know, it was just like a rotating process. And I dropped one, and it had, and I only had enough wood to make about what we needed and the ones to do these without having to go into Salt Lake, which is half hour drive north to get this wood that I use.
Because they don't have this.
And they're closed tomorrow, so I was like, oh no.
We had just enough. We thought we weren't going to have enough, but we had enough for our boxes.
So our calculations were correct, and we're using the ones that I dropped. They glued back together pretty well.
You could also add some green to the bottom if you want to add some, you know, grass or whatever.
I may have made these too detailed.
Yeah, I was like, you made these a little bit different.
That brush over there might work a little better.
I missed some brown. Did I just hit my bun on your head?
Yeah.
Man, this is the I've been working all day here.
It was an accidental bunning.
My bun was really high this morning. I had to put the seat down. It was hitting the roof of the car in the Expedition.
All right, the dab method is working for me.
Ooh, Leslie's excited. She moves on the 10th.
All right. Where are you moving to, Leslie? Down the street or big move?
Pam, we are live. Jamie says you can always substitute or give me fixed pieces. I'm not picky. Lolly, you're cute. We're only going to put out the good stuff to our subscription boxes. But we could sell, like, the half-broken stuff in store. We do that sometimes. The locals love it. We're like, so this kind of broke. I don't want to dirty another brush. I'll wait till you're done.
Okay.
All right, I'm going to show you the paper I'm using. This is called newsprint. It's one of the least purchased papers of all the decoupage paper at jamierayvintage.com. And I think it's so cool, especially for something like this. So this is how big when you buy just the paper. This is how big each sheet is. And it's tissue paper, so it's nice and thin. So this is the newsprint. In the kits, you're only getting this much paper because this is all you need for this project. But if you buy the whole sheet, this is how big they are. So, give you an idea.
All right, that's going to be the back side, all right? We're just going
to... Oh, super chat from At Home with Mama Marge. Hi, oh, love this project and enjoy watching all your various projects. Thanks. We like projecting. This is actually the funnest thing I've done all day.
Well, I cut these out special for, like, and designed them special just for the box.
Yeah, it was fun. That's actually, Tavern Green is really pretty. So Tavern Green is farmhouse finishes. I believe if you're using Sweet Pickens, it would be called In a Pickle.
Yes.
That is In a Pickle. And then we're using Suitcase by Sweet Pickens. And there's a similar color with farmhouse finishes that's brown. Can't remember the name. But the only difference is if this was not on MDF, Sweet Pickens chips, farmhouse finishes doesn't chip as much. But when you're painting on raw wood, it doesn't chip.
It's just going to soak it up.
It just soaks.
And I'm putting it on thin enough. If you wanted it to chip, I would seal it first. Then
you've been green everywhere.
I know. I'm going to have to
maybe we should have painted the trees.
I'm
going
to have to repaint my brown. So do this in reverse of me.
Well, paint just your... make some grass.
Oh, there you go. I'm just trying to get the sides. I don't even know if I'm going to paint that backside.
I'm not really going to worry about them. Like, if you want to be super specific about your sides, you can go right on ahead. So let's see. Leslie says the newsprint is gorgeous. Oh, and I forgot to say, so these are $5.95 a sheet for the decoupage papers. These are $19.95. If you bought the kit, you got a good deal because just this and the brush, that's $14.95, is basically what you paid for the kit. And you got the paint and the wax and the top coat and the decoupage paper. So if you didn't buy a craft box, make sure you sign up the next time we open them back up again. And maybe someday we'll do them more than once a quarter, but right now, that's all we got time for. I think everybody at the shop would disown me. Lolly says, I'm going to do a different style on each side. I like it. I think if you were super careful, you could probably get both sides done with the two sheets. I only thought about doing one side because I don't ever think about painting the backs of things, but...
Okay.
So they're cute just like that.
I was going to say, I made a whole forest of these. If you check out my Instagram, you can see the big stack of them on the table that I had. my Instagram is at RayWire.
I'm going to actually share your picture on my Instagram.
Jamie's going to put my picture on her Instagram, so you get to see it there.
I didn't have time to take a picture of anything pretty. The only thing pretty that was happening around here was stuff in boxes.
That's I'm going to go grab a paper towel real quick so I can wipe up my green, and then I'm going to get that dry, and we'll start decoupaging.
Jean and I also did enjoy a delicious oat milk cookie with Biscoff frosting. That was exciting today.
Those cookies were really good.
If you're local to Utah, you can get them at Twisted Sugar. The Coastal Chic says, hello, so excited I actually came across this live. Yeah, we actually were planning on doing an edited video, but being that these boxes have to be shipped out by the end of the month, which is tomorrow, we had to do the video today because I'm putting a link in every box. In fact, all the boxes are sitting over there open with the labels already printed on them, waiting for my little sheet of paper. Guys, Zeb, next time, not so much detail, man. If you have like a little artist brush, I would suggest that because this is a lot of detail.
Not as much detail, but look how good they look.
They green. Do look good, but I think I'd use a little tiny brush.
There's a couple little peekaboos here, but look at that. Like,
I'm not worried.
That looks like a tree. Yeah, Christmas tree.
You did kind of miss the sides a little.
Yeah.
It's okay. By the time we decoupage them and white wax them.
That's what I figured.
Them,
like, you could probably.
We got a lot of steps coming. It'll be fine. All right. Do you want to heat gun that?
Yep.
Where did you go?
I had to go get a paper towel so that I could...
Oh, I have a whole roll right here.
Oh, that's where they went to. I knew I saw them in here earlier.
I always have paper towels in here.
Okay, so just heat gunning to get them dry so we can get the project done in a timely manner.
I could have included a foam brush with the kit, but I wanted to give you guys a nice brush.
Yeah, that's part of the value of the
kit. I wanted to entice people to buy the subscription box, so I splurged.
What, the cutouts weren't enough?
Well, the cutouts were good, but then in case the cutouts weren't enough, I'm like, also you get this amazing brush with the $14.95 value. Oh, Caitlin's on here. What did Caitlin say? Oh, she said, hey, Jean. We talked about all kinds of things today. It was actually really fun filling the boxes with Jean and Christy.
It was like
here.
A boxing party?
Yeah, it was fun. We have a good time together. It's less fun when they have to ship the random stuff that I buy.
I spent all day researching plumbing and second-guessing myself.
That's all right. Mike's going to come over tomorrow and he's going to set you straight.
Yep. Mike from Budget Plumbing has been, they've been doing the HVAC and he's going to, he came over to check on the HVAC guys and he's like, hey, let me show you a couple things on your plumbing so that, you don't fail your inspection.
He's so good. It pays to have handy friends. I'm trying to get all the cracks. This is a little bit difficult. It's like crafting level 2.
Okay.
You know what? If I had painted this flat and then went like this while I was on the table, that would have been easier.
Can you pass me a new brush and the top coat?
What?
So that one, the reason that that one is part of our sample one is because I sanded it way too much and it didn't fit down tight.
So you're going to get top coat in a 2-ounce jar. I didn't save a 2-ounce jar for me, so we're pouring it out.
It's like glitter in this jar, in this mug.
Oh, and you're definitely not going to need a full 2 ounces. Oh, so this is just one single sample. So you're going to need your whole sample because I don't know if it's going to be enough for me.
Just add more water.
Yeah, okay. I have more.
Go with a wash.
You get your own, but we're sharing.
And can I get a brush?
How do you get a brush? So I got this.
Okay.
Is it all the way dry? That is not all the way dry. You're going to get green everywhere.
Okay. Let me fix this so I don't get green everywhere. Got a thick spot. I am getting a little bit of crackle using the heat gun.
That is true. So you can use green down. You can use Sweet Pickens top coat to decoupage as long as it's thin, like tissue paper or napkins. If it's thicker, then I would suggest using big DIY's liquid patina. And this in no way means that I love milk paint more than DIY paint. It just means that I can get milk paint by the gallon, which I can't. You can too, actually. All right.
And it's really craft box friendly.
It is craft box friendly. Especially next month when I put it in Ziploc bags instead of little containers. But they do look cute.
Okay.
I need to fix my base. I have shoved it way too far, and now it's not level.
It's okay. I can glue it in later for you.
All right. I got
grass. All right.
I got grass dripping.
That's... So I've got a little bit of heat going. Some spots are dry. Some spots are trying to be dry, and I got crackle in other spots. So let your paint just dry on its
own. You want crackle.
Now, I was thinking, I don't know if I want to cut this up or if I just want to, like... Put it on here and rip it.
I was planning on cutting mine, but not exact size. Like, I'm going to decoupage it, and then I'm going to use sandpaper to, like, break it off the edge.
Okay.
I did not include sandpaper in your kit, so don't hold your breath for that one.
I think I'm going to try
to... You could just rip it. Oh, that's a lot of drippy. I think when you added water to this...
I think I am just going to rip it
too much.
So that it has... Yeah, it got real runny when I added the water.
I think you just wanted my project to look weird.
No. I would never sabotage your project.
Would you not?
No. Unless there was a competition.
And then maybe.
And then all bets are off because I like to win.
Cheating is not winning, sir. Alright, that's good enough. Alright, I'm going to wipe off the extra paint and then I'm going to fix it and then I'm going
to
dry it.
I'm ripping the pages because I want it to have kind of more of an organic look rather than a cut look. So I'm just kind of tearing the edges off a little bit.
I'm going to have to go back in the live chat and see what everybody suggested for boxes and...
Oh, did you ask and then you missed it?
Well, yeah, you said I had to focus on what I'm doing because people don't want to just watch me talk.
Alright.
They're here for the
tutorial. So, to decoupage, the right paper really helps, but... I'm just going to put the top coat on, nice, generous coat. Not going to wait for it to dry.
My live chat went away.
I don't know what's going on with YouTube today. Okay.
Did you cut it?
I ripped it. And then I'm going to put this on over the trees.
Oh, that's...
While my paper, while my... top coat is still wet. I'm just kind of smoothing out any wrinkles that I had because I wasn't super careful to make sure there weren't wrinkles when I was laying it down.
You can also use an iron.
Yep, an iron will work.
Once it's dry. Or put like a sheet of wax paper and then iron it.
Okay, and now I'm going back over with the top coat. Just saturating that paper. Not so much that it's like gonna rip.
So really one kit is enough for two tree sets.
Yeah, if you water your paint down, I mean, look, that tree looks as good as my trees over here.
Yeah, there you have it. Well, I wanted to make sure everybody had enough paint. Nothing's worse than getting a kit and not having enough products. Okay, now I'm just fixing my bottom. Yeah.
Okay. Now I'm just going to take my finger.
Like it never happened.
All right, so here we are. And before that starts drying, I'm just going to rip the edges where they're nice and soft because they're wet.
Why paint is fun. Because you can just paint over it. No problemo. I'm not gonna try that again.
This paper's got a really good weight. What's the weight on this paper? Do you know?
I think it's 18 pounds. Don't hold me to it because I've only had one cookie and a tater tot. Tater tots.
I got her a burrito on my way here and didn't check to make sure it was in the bag.
Is that the first time that my food's been missing because you didn't check the bag?
No, and by the time I knew, I had already eaten my whole burger, so I couldn't even offer her some burger. I'm like, here,
well,
I have some
tots.
The
last time you offered me a burger, you threw it, and it landed on my forehead. You threw it in a fit of rage.
That was like 20 years ago now.
Yeah. Wow. We haven't even been married 20 years. It was like 14 years ago. That Disneyland trip was rough. There was a lot of days in the Disney.
It's too many. I will say that.
All right. That's dry enough. Okay. Now I'm going to get to your part next.
Okay.
So I'm going to... Can you move this paint before I wear it?
Yeah.
Tissue paper is awesome. You can also decoupage with napkins. And if you go to JRV Home, which is our home decor website, we actually have Christmas tree napkins, and they're cute. And you get a lot for like $2. So if you don't mind pulling apart all the layers, it is cheaper to decoupage with napkins. Just saying.
So this is so detailed. I'm just taking the edge of the brush and knocking down the paper where I couldn't rip it.
I don't need all this. This side.
Oh, I'm getting some green from the sides that weren't dry. Watch out for that.
If you get your decoupage paper and it has, we put each of them in a sheet protector, but it's possible it could shift in transit, shift high in transit, S-H-I-T.
Shift high, whatever. Store high.
You can totally store iron high. Your decoupage paper if it gets wrinkled, so don't worry. Or you could just put it on crinkled and it could add a great textured effect. But Jean was really good at trying to make sure that they were nice and flat. Okay, so I'm gonna do...
Okay, all my edges are pretty well ripped and conform over the edge like I wanted it to. I'm leaving the top of that tree green and undecoupaged. And it'll lighten back up as it dries. Right now, it's really picking up the green from the trees.
Can I have the brush, please?
Yeah.
Caitlin says, I wish I could take my boys to Disney. We'll have to go another year. I know, Caitlin, man. This is not the year for trips. I mean, I guess you could go to Disney World if you want to go to Florida.
So I have all of this done, and I probably had enough notes and things that I could carry that over with the ripped piece over here. But I'm gonna do, I can't decide, should I do the bells and the mushrooms and the berries and stuff, or should I do this half of the postcard sign over here somewhere? I'll wait for a sec while Jami gets hers going. I'm gonna rip them out.
I'm hoping I'm not like irritated at the fact that there's a lot of detail in this. There we go.
Yep, it rips it. You know what? It has, because it's so detailed, it's got kind of some sharp edges.
It's like a serrated edge. Look at that.
Yeah, it's boom. Like got some sharp edges and it just comes right off. And I just used the edge of the brush to carefully poke it down in between so I didn't lose all that detail. Or you could use your finger. My finger was too big.
Oh, my finger is just right.
Can you peek over there and see what people are saying? Do they want to see the wreath and the bell or...
Here.
Oh.
I'm busy. Busy man.
Lakefront Thrift, great tip here. If you use plastic wrap over the decoupage and rub it, it takes away any air bubbles and wrinkles.
Oh, well, there you go. Extra tips from other people.
We got a great community of people who know how to craft.
Y'all are better at crafting than us, but we appreciate you watching us even though you exceed our crafting ability. Okay, I'm just gonna take a dry brush and just push this back.
Looks like I've got one vote for post. There's a few votes for postcard. Okay, I'll count them.
There we go. That's working.
The bells win. It's 4-5.
That so far. But we gotta get moving. We gotta make an executive decision.
You know what? I'll do the bells on this side, and then I'll do the postcard on the back side, so you can see.
I think mine is cute. All right, I'm just using this dry brush to come across here.
I feel like the bells work because I have music notes over here. So good call.
Good call on the bells. And like I said, you can use the brush we gave you for your entire project.
Yeah, you just need to wash it out in between steps.
Okay, I think I got that, all the detail in there. All right, there's one. One of my trees. I have quite a bit left over. I could probably use this on the back of one. All right, I'm going to use this part, the new meat chopper. That's good. That's going to go in the middle. It's the family size. It's $3. I want a meat chopper for $3. But I also don't want to make only $200 a month salary.
Yeah, you got to factor in inflation.
Inflation. All right. So nobody is getting this paper in their craft kit. You're only getting that one. But.
I did the bells, and then lots of people weighed in with the postcard. I'll do the postcard on the other side.
Sorry, we're getting there. You're using the brush. Thanks, Leslie. Jasmine says she likes both. Do we get a sampler brush? I wasn't listening. No, you get this brush, the Zibra brush.
Maybe in a future kit.
Well, there'll be different brushes coming at you.
Because we're gonna.
I need to look at the price point. I get better breaks on certain brushes, and I'm not gonna lie. I can't give you a $10 brush and a $36 kit. I mean, $10 retail. Let's talk real numbers here.
Well, and we'll give you a few different brushes and things though, so that you have like a variety.
And once you guys get a ton of brushes, then it may come to a point where you get more of other stuff for your kit.
Yeah.
So, you just never know. It's all going to be good. And even if you duplicate a brush, you need more than one of the same brush. I have 400 of each brush because I don't like to wash them. They sit in the sink in water, which you should not do with your brushes. It's not a good idea. And then eventually somebody takes pity on me, or they can't stand the smell of the paint because everything I use is all natural, so it will go bad. It smells like Sasha's dad from Sweet Pickens. He says it smells like rotten broccoli. Because Sasha does the same thing. Her sink is always full of brushes. And her dad's like, how come it smells like rotten broccoli? And she's like, because the paint's all natural. Can I have that brush?
Yep.
Leslie says she bought brushes when they were on sale, our semi-annual sale.
Okay, I'm gonna do the other side here real quick with just the...
So I'm just using the side of this dry brush to just push it in. You could use your finger, too. Or you could rip it the way Zeb's doing it. And piece it on there. You can also, when it's all the way dry, hit it with sandpaper across the edge, and that'll get rid of any loose paper. It's not stuck to your piece. Okay, we got the second one on here.
You almost don't even have to rip your paper. If you just cut it to size and then work over the edges, the tree, if you have enough top coat on there, the tree will do all the work for you.
All those ripped edges.
Yep.
Maybe I should just Google it, but I prefer to learn from Jami and Zeb. Really, decoupage, you want a clean surface that's not super shiny, and you put a coat of the top coat or your decoupage, whatever you're using, the liquid patina, we're using top coat, put a coat of that down, you put your tissue paper, you put more on top, and then you let it dry. That's it.
Well, and the tissue paper is really the factor, the right kind of paper. We tried doing decoupage with posters.
It was hard.
And it took a ton of liquid patina.
If you're going to be using posters, you need to use liquid patina or wallpaper. Remember when we did wallpaper?
Mm-hmm.
I feel like I'm going to need to just use my own brush.
You might.
Because
I got some green on
this one.
Well,
this one's too big.
Ooh, I really like the postcard. I gotta do some more ripping on the edges, but check that out.
Check out what Zeph did.
Okay, I'm gonna attempt to dry these real quick so you can see what they look like dry.
And then I think you might need to use a little sandpaper around the edge or just kind of wear it off with your finger.
Yeah.
You want to be liberal with your top coat because that's what keeps it from bubbling, especially the tissue paper. It really works well.
Well, and I might bubble it using the heat gun, so keep that in mind. Just let it dry. Don't heat gun
it
because you're in a hurry.
Don't force the issue.
And if you don't want to rip them, if you want to be like really neat and exact, you can also do that too. And like, I've seen people do stripes with their decoupage. The sky's the limit with what you can do with these.
No, in our craft kit, you have to do it exactly the way we do. Just cutting. We give you tools, you do you. I don't mind if it doesn't cover at all because I want a little bit of the green tree to like show through. And it will show through the tissue paper anyways.
All right, let me show you this mid-dry. I think it's...
Mid-dry?
It's pretty well dry. It's a little tacky still, but you can see how some of the green faded away. And now you can really see the deer and the bell and the music sheets. There's a butterfly up here in the corner up here.
Well, you did both sides, and now I have to do both sides.
Well, I only did one postcard in the middle. Tree.
And you do not have to seal it again after you decoupage it. Like, that's enough sealer for your whole project. If you want to seal the whole thing, then you can seal over the ground stuff, too. Alright.
Tanya, it would be good to stencil the other side.
You can, if you've got stencils, you know, you can...
You can just, you know, we send you the kit. What you do with it is your own prerogative. We are excited to see all the different variations in the group and on your pages and everybody linking stuff.
All right, I'm just using the leftovers here.
I'm a llama mama. I think it was Debbie just recently did a video on decoupaging fabric.
Did she decoupage fabric?
I think so.
I don't think so.
Maybe it's a video coming out and I saw it on the back end of stuff.
I don't know.
If that's the case,
maybe
I'm sorry.
Maybe she is doing decoupage fabric. I'm just doing lots of decoupage on the back.
All right, I'm going to sand it just a little bit. Do you have the sandpaper over here?
I do.
I'm going to sand my base because I got green all over. We got some grass to go with the dirt.
You can paint it.
Oh, I actually like the reverse of the light wood coming through underneath.
We should say light MDF.
Did you see what I did there? I called it wood. It's sawdust and glue. It's wood. It's the same as paper, almost.
I need more top coat.
It's like thick paper.
Have more top coat?
Oh, yeah. Thanks. Patricia, thank you. I'm glad that I can still surprise people. You know, it's usually a train wreck in my situation, and then I pull it out in the end.
You're so good at the pull out of the train wreck.
Yeah.
Alright, I don't know what I'm doing here. I got tired of being very particular, so I just pieced together the back. Also an option to just piece it together.
Alright, not loving.
I feel like piecing it together works with this newsprint.
So my green drips don't look like grass, they look like drips. So I'm going back home with the brown. I tried to sand away the shame, and I could not.
The shame in your
game. The shame of the drips.
It's a drippy shame. It's a dripping shame!
Let me just dry that off, and then I'll show you. It's pretty much complete. It's got a couple little spots that need to dry. But
not white wax.
White wax.
You can also use your paintbrush to apply the white wax. Go wash it. When I first started doing stuff, I only owned one paintbrush, and I used it for 3 years. No joke.
I have a picture on the hard drive somewhere of that paintbrush, because I tried to use it in a logo for something, and you vetoed it because the paintbrush was so crusty looking. It just didn't look good.
I was poor, man. I didn't have multiple brushes. I had a paintbrush, and I slapped paint on everything with the universal brush. All right, that's good. I'll sand it the rest of the way.
Okay. So there is the craft kit. Now to white wax. I just white wax the edges and see if we can get a snow effect. Is that what it's
for? Get like a whole ounce of white wax, so you can use it for something.
There's a lot of white wax in here.
I really...
Like, what's a sample of
white
wax?
I probably need to keep that. Yeah, 2 ounce in the Sweet Pickens, but yes, a sample is 4 ounces. But at any length, I probably should put less of each thing in the kit. Maybe next time I will. This time you get extra, because we're learning. It's a new thing. I've never had a subscription box before.
At least not a craft one.
I also hadn't done the craft yet, so I wasn't sure how much everybody was going to need.
You're getting the inaugural. That's why I said yesterday when we were doing it, I'd be like, we'll see how it ends up.
Yeah, I would rather give people more than they need.
We've been so busy, like, this has not been an afterthought. We fully intended on having this done like a month ago.
Speaking of which, Zeb, you posted on your Instagram that I asked you last night to make these. You designed these weeks ago, and I've been telling you for the last 2 weeks that you needed to cut them out.
Well, I designed them when you did the initial
picture. I've been reminding you for the last 2 weeks that you needed to cut them out. You made it seem like I just asked you last night, hey, could you just do this, and you just did it.
Well, that's the magic of Instagram.
You embellished your Instagram.
I
commented it and said it straight.
It felt pretty straight when I said it. I was up 7 hours last night.
You were up 7 hours because you waited till the last minute, not because I waited to ask you. You would have told me tough noogies. Well, no.
No, I knew it was coming.
I know, but if I had waited until last night to tell you that we needed to do these, I think you probably wouldn't have been as amenable. But you waited because you waited. Because you've been busy building a house. Oops. I got stuff. I kind of undid the stuff from this side. All right. That's good. Where's the heat gun? Okay, there's mine. This is where I just like layered the back. And this is the front one. It's just a clean design.
So in light of how much wax is in there, you can white wax the whole thing if you want. But I just did like a little dusting of snow on the tops of a couple trees. I feel like that's winning.
Jean says this is a blessing box because I'm blessing him with more than is necessary.
I love it, Jean.
Jean is always the bright side of every situation.
All right.
I just said all right, and you said all right. I am going to need sandpaper, I think, on the edge of this.
So here's the faraway view.
Because it's kind of messy.
I almost need, like, something... Oh, I got it figured out.
Where's the white wax?
I already white waxed it.
Oh, that's cute!
And look how much wax I didn't use.
It worked just like I thought in my mind. You cannot order the winter subscription box anymore, but you can order the trees and the decoupage paper at JamieRayVintage.com.
So the subscription box is like a special value that we offered for this particular one, but you can get all the stuff individually if you really want to do it. Or if you just want the cutout, because you've got all the supplies at home to do all of this. All right, does that help you see it a little better? I feel like you're burning your paper.
Yeah, it caught on fire a little bit. It's okay, it's an extra effect. You know when people burn the paper to make it look old?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's what I'm doing.
It's on purpose. What I need is a light box.
A light box?
Yeah, we should really have one of those.
What are you doing? Are you trying to like...
I'm taking the Lehi poster that is no longer relevant.
That's that. Harrison's not on that one.
No, he's not.
That's the 2020 schedule. They're done. Did you know we have some Lehi swag in there I haven't taken home?
I saw it.
We don't.
There we go. Now we're talking. That's still too far away to see.
I'm not done yet, Deb. I started after you.
Yeah, you could use the brown paint if you wanted to do... That's a good idea on the edges. Whose idea was that?
You could use it as a wash to age it.
It was Lolly. Yeah, you could almost use it like a...
antiquing glaze?
Yeah, like a glaze. On
I mentioned that earlier, Zeb. You didn't hear me?
Missed it.
It's weird that you would miss something that I said.
I know.
So weird. Because I know you wait. I say a lot of things, so it's probably hard to keep up. All right.
So Stacy says in the 70s that they would burn the paper before they used it.
Okay. It's not like all the way dry. So I need to wait.
Oh, the postcard has been neglected. I haven't showed the postcard side because that's also an option.
If when you're distressing it or if you... Sorry. If you use sandpaper and you pull any of it up, you can always just put more top coat on there, so don't freak out. It's not a big deal. You can always repodge the decoupage. I'm just gonna sand it all, I think. Give it a kind of an age look. Oh, I like that.
Alright.
Oh, I like it.
Are you sure it's dry?
No, it's dryish. I'm just sanding the whole thing.
Gotcha.
To like age the paper a little. See?
I like how yours goes over all the trees.
Well, that was my idea.
We had two different effects
going. I didn't tell you what the box was supposed to do. I didn't give you the instructions.
She didn't give me any instructions. I was like, all right, so how's this supposed to look? She's like, make it your own.
Paint it and put some paper on it. All right, it's really not dry in the back. All right, I'm going to just...
So I got a little bit of snow on the dirt down below.
I'll show you guys mine in a minute. I'm not done yet. Deb was hogging the decoupage medium.
Glitter would be awesome.
We did not include glitter because some people have feelings about glitter.
I have feelings about glitter. We always end up using
it. And it actually is not good for the environment.
It's true.
It is true. And if you want, you can glue this in. You way over sanded mine.
I didn't sand yours at all.
No, I'm talking about the base.
Oh, yeah, your base is a little wobbly.
My base.
That's why it's on the... We get to use it.
Yeah, I get all the seconds. Mm-hmm. Okay, where's that white wax? Where's the white wax? Oh, did you get your own brush? I had a wax brush right here.
I did. And I've just been...
Oh, that's probably big. Are you going
to
go...
It is a little big to fit in there.
Yeah.
It was convenient because I could just fit like the edge of it
in. Yeah, this brush that you get actually fits perfectly. It's hot.
Oh, they've got all the ideas for us. Pennies from Heaven, some Golden Ticket would be cool on there.
I'm getting a little snow.
They had the best feelings about glitter.
She has feelings about glitter.
Yeah.
I'm putting snow on mine.
All right.
Sorry, I'm taking a little long. I'm almost done, guys, I promise.
It's okay. It's a Friday hangout because we probably won't get, to be honest, we're probably not going to get another farmhouse video out because I was doing these into the wee hours of the night and then had to do a little bit of sanding this morning. And I've been doing plumbing, which we already showed you. I've still been doing that. So.
All right. You know what the cool thing is, though? We will be live tomorrow night for the thrift haul because our kids are going to be done. Our little boys will be done by... The time with Rick Paul starts.
It's dark at like 6 here, yeah. 6:30, so they'll be around the block and finished, and we'll scoot over here and do the thrift haul.
And I think I'm just going to put a bowl of candy on the front porch where they can keep their little dirty, germy hands to themselves.
Make it a disposable bowl. We'll just kick it to the trash
can.
Like,
when the bowl is empty, would you please just throw it away in the garbage can, thanks.
All right, show them yours.
Okay.
You're fussing with it too much.
There you go.
Oh, here's you got mine. Both sides done with yours.
Yeah, didn't you do both sides?
Kinda. I have like one postcard on the back.
Oh, you just did the butt of one of your trees.
Well, I wanted to show them what the postcard could look like, because I didn't. I did have some paper left over that I could have used with my two sheets, but...
And you don't have to use the white wax if you don't want to, but I thought it'd be fun to make it look like snow. So
here, let's put them on the fake light box. Show them.
You didn't sand yours on the edge that much. You gotta fix your edges.
My edges are fine.
On the back.
On the back, I wasn't all worried right. about it. The so back
this is
unfinished.
The paper you're gonna get.
This is the kit here. Jami went rogue.
Mm-hmm. If you didn't get a subscription box, don't worry. You can get the tree trio for $19.95 and the decoupage paper for $5.95, and then you can supply your own other stuff. At JamieRayVintage.com. And if you want the subscription box, make sure you're signing up for our newsletter on our website, both at JamieRayVintage.com and JRVHome.com, because as soon as they are available, Caitlin is going to send a mass email, and I'll put it on all the socials so you can sign up for next month. And if you signed up for this month, you're already signed up for the next quarter unless you cancel.
We'll probably start designing the spring one as soon as next week, or at least getting ideas together for it.
The next 2 weeks.
It'll be soon. It has to happen, so.
All right, you guys, have a great weekend. We will see you tomorrow night for our thrift haul. Be sure to give us a thumbs up and subscribe to Jami Raven Ditch for more
DIY.
Love you guys. And if you got subscription boxes, thank you for supporting us. If you got thrift boxes coming, you're going to be excited.
Jami was so excited about those. Fun.